Hello everyone, myself Payal. So in this video I'm going to transfer this flower vase which I bought it from a thrift store, and I'm going to transfer it with the transfer sheet. So first I'm going to make my own paste. So for that I'm going to take one part of tacky glue, two part of white acrylic paint, and then I'm going to take one part of baking powder, and then I'm going to mix all these three ingredients together to make my own paste. The surface of this flower vase is a glossy and it's a glass, but I want matte ceramic texture, so that's why here I have created my own paste. With the help of this paste you can get a ceramic texture on the top of this flower vase, and here I am using this stencil brush and I'm just stabbing this paste on the top of this vase, so it's gonna create a beautiful texture on a base. So when you are using this paste with this kind of the brush, it gonna create some brush stroke on a surface, but just keep it like this because this texture looks so good. So that's why I'm just randomly dabbing my brush on top of this vase. And after that I'm going to apply the same paste on this glass jar. This is a glass and it's very glossy and shiny, but when you apply this paste it's gonna create a beautiful ceramic effect on top of this glass, which I'll just love it. So here I am applying this paste in a horizontal direction, so it's gonna create some horizontal stroke on a glass jar which looks like that you made this pot in a ceramic wheel or a ceramic pottery wheel. So that's why here I am using this horizontal stroke, and after that just let it dry it completely, and then I am going to make another paste for the coloring. And as you can see, my jar is dried completely. After that, I'm going to make another paste. So for that, here I'm taking one part of white glue, two part of white acrylic paint, and then I'm going to take little bit turquoise acrylic paint, and then I'm going to add one part of baking powder, and then mix all these ingredients together very nicely. So after that I have created this turquoise paste, and it's like light turquoise shade. So then I'm going to apply this paste in a horizontal direction with the same brush as you can see in a video. So there isn't any kind of the fixed measurement to make a paste. Here I have just taken all these three ingredients randomly. You just have to make a texture very smooth of this paste so you can easily apply with the brush. So it's a try and error thing. When you add a baking powder into your paste, it's gonna create some fluffiness, so which is the correct thing to get a perfect texture. So here I am applying this paste in a horizontal stroke, and the same way I'm going to apply the paste on top of this glass jar. So now it's time for the distressing. Here I am using this Ranger distress ink, and I'm applying this ink very smoothly on top of my surface. So here I'm just applying it, and you just have to keep your hand very smooth so you will not get any kind of the extra distress, and it gives a beautiful distress effect on your base. I just love it. Like, this is my favorite process to do it. Distressing technique change your project. It gives a very good dimension to your base, so I just love this process. And now it's time for the transform sheet. Here I'm going to use RestMyCraft transform sheet. I'm going to mention all the product list in a description box so you can buy it. So here I'm using this vintage script kind of thing which has a butterfly, and I just love this design. So first I'm just removing it from the packaging, and then fussy cut the element which you really want to transfer it on your flower vase. So after fussy cutting of this transform sheet, now I'm going to transfer it on my base. So here I am peeling off the film on top of this transform sheet, and I'm going to stick this transform sheet on my base as you can see in a video. And after that I'm going to use wet tissue paper, and I'm applying some water on top of this transform sheet. So as you can see, the base image of this transform sheet is revealing slowly, and you just have to apply the water with very soft hand. So when your transfer images are ready, you can easily slide this paper as you can see in a video, and this part is so satisfying. I just love it. Here I'm just removing this paper slowly as you can see in a video, and ta-da! Your transfer image is ready. And then I'm just applying this dry tissue paper on top of it to stick this transform sheet completely on my base. So the same way I'm going to use transform sheet on this glass jar. Transform sheets are very easy to use it, and it's pocket friendly, like you can easily buy it. I would recommend all of you to use transform sheet once in your any of the project. In my description box, I'm going to mention website of Crafters Corner or Address My Craft, so you can buy it from them. And it's very easy to use it, it's pocket friendly, and it's gonna change your project completely. So definitely try it. So the same way I'm going to use this transform sheet on a glass jar, and oh my god, I just love the result of the transform sheet. I'm obsessed with it actually. So in this way, my both the projects are ready and they look so amazing. If you want more tutorials, then make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And that's all about today's video. I'll see you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye bye.